In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect two Bluetooth speakers to an iPhone or iPad. But before I start off with the video, please make sure that you do not skip and watch the video because there'll be a lot of steps, and if you miss any of the steps in between, your connection might not be proper. So without much ado, let's jump into it. This is Sonit from Techitrickle. Two speakers, one phone. It sounds like a perfect recipe for a party or an intimate setting, but setting up your iPhone or iPad to do this might be quite difficult. And that's exactly why I have this video for you. Now for step one, on the iPad or iPhone, go to settings, Bluetooth. Make sure that the Bluetooth is on and discoverable. You'll also need the latest version of the iOS software installed on your device. Now to see this, go to Settings, General, and then About. And then look for the software version 6 or later at the top of the page. For step 2, turn on both the speakers you want to connect to your iPhone or iPad, making sure that they are visible in the list of available devices. The connection process might take a minute or two, so do not get impatient and turn it off while you're waiting. Now we come to step 3. Now when you have detected both the speakers, select one of them and then follow the instructions on your iPhone or iPad to connect it. Sometimes this is done by entering a passcode, the same as the Bluetooth passcode displayed on your speaker, or sometimes by pressing the buttons on both the speakers simultaneously. Try each speaker initially with as little interruption as possible between starting up the connection process and completing it. If there is no sound coming out when connected, try turning off the airplane mode if for some reason that got switched on. And you should be able to hear music back again almost immediately after turning the mode back off. For step 4, repeat step 2 and 3 for each additional speaker setup you want to add. You don't have to pair each speaker with your iPhone or iPad individually. Now, if you want to connect a third speaker, for example, you will need to take the first two speakers off the connection and then simply add the third. This may not work for every individual setup though. It's best to keep all paired Bluetooth devices in the same state if possible, either connected and streaming or disconnected. Now we come to step 5. Switch from multi-speaker mode back to single speaker mode by going to Settings, Bluetooth, and making sure that any additional devices aren't listed there. If you want to reconnect them at some point, just repeat step 2 and 3 that I mentioned just a few minutes back. For step 6, in order to adjust the sound levels coming out of each speaker, you will need to manually alter the volume on each. And you can do so by going to Settings, Music, and then selecting the volume limit. From here, you switch it off if it isn't already and adjust your maximum volumes so that they are calibrated correctly across all speakers. Now, additionally, when playing music through an iOS device using the Bluetooth multi-speaker setup, the sound levels will be controlled from within the individual iOS application, for example, the Spotify or iTunes. Now, comment below and let me know how many Bluetooth speakers you wanted to connect to your iPhone or iPad. Now, there are a lot of such videos that are there on my channel, so please make sure that you watch them and browse them also. Now, I would really appreciate if you can give me a like and also subscribe to my channel, clicking the notification bell so that you are notified as soon as I come up with such videos again. Please share this video with all your friends and family in social media because YouTube likes that engagement. Now, there are two videos that are coming up right now on your screen, so please make sure that you watch them till the end. Till the next time, bye-bye.